With honor and integrity, we will safeguard the American people, our homeland, and our values. Federal Commission on Safety, on School Safety, report to the President. These are written on the Homeland Security website, ending legal loopholes and securing our border. Now, I had made a video earlier about the importance of studying. The reason why it's so important for people to study and not to depend on any one outside of themselves for security. If you cannot reach someone, you must know what to say, how to operate, and what to do. Now, if you're traveling, Sir the Duke of Tears was mentioning there's a whole lot of stuff going on globally, which is why we posted the video earlier, and we suggest everybody go and watch that video. When you're traveling, you need to do an affidavit. Here's what we did. We did an affidavit to the Prime Minister here and to all, when we got here, to all the ministers. We went and visited them long before we traveled. When we're traveling, we write to Homeland Security now and tell them we're traveling, where we're traveling to, how long we intend to stay, as they will escort you as a national, right? Hence, you must know law in order to stand your ground in whatever the situation is, especially if you have someone claiming to not know that they're in Morocco and they don't know anything about the Moors, which you know they're lying, but they're looking for you to have validity in what you're saying too, in terms of how to back up your position as a national. Nationals are not just a matter of carrying the Ivy Bay Publications card or the Moorish American Consulate identification card. There's much more to it than that. Those of us who are out here studying for years and years and years on end know that in order to protect oneself, one must be able to stand in light of what's going on. Now, I don't even recommend people traveling at this particular time, quite frankly, because there's too much stuff happening. And I'm not certain with this. I know we had leaned, the Moorish American Council had leaned all of these pretender agents doing business as public governance. And as a result of that, Asir was saying they're using this shutdown to impose all kinds of crap while they themselves are being subjected to scrutiny because of the fraud that they've committed on all of us. So internationally, I'm speaking to all agents internationally now, go and look into this matter and speak to the agents at Homeland Security for the more that just contacted me to make certain that they are protected and they are well cared for and they are able to return to their children, right? Now, speak to the head at Department of Homeland Security and let him understand the seriousness of his position as it's fraud, and they may be European colonists occupying the lands, and they may not have a foreign registration statement, and they may not have an anti-bribery statement, and they probably don't have a delegation of authority order, and they may be European colonists occupying our lands. And as such, if maybe they're also Deputy Knights Templars, maybe they're Crown Temple agents, right? And as you know, the Clearfield Doctrine stands and there's no statute of limitations on fraud. Hence, they can be lien in their private capacity up to 75,000 punitive damages, 75,000 compensatory damages payable in lawful money and or fiat equivalent, right? And also for defamation of character up to 75,000 in lawful money for that as well. So those of you out there listening to me, you need to study out the antitrust laws. You need to study out the Federal Trade Commission. You need to study out, to me, it's all mail fraud, 18 U.S.C. 1341 and telecommunications for fraud 1343. Because remember, all the other documents basically that they're using, aside from the nationality card, is basically under fraud because they've put everybody under this wardship status. You who have come out of wardship status must be able to stand on that. Why I travel with an affidavit. So if I'm traveling, I have the affidavit on my purse, on my hand, so that if I'm questioned or anything, and my hearing shuts down or my vision shuts down or I have some kind of, you know, whatever injuries, because I know that I have issues with other stuff in my own physical body, the people there have to be protected. And how I protect them is having the affidavit that I've sent to the Homeland Security, or I've sent to the Prime Minister, I've sent to the airport, right? I have a copy of that affidavit. It states where I'm going, who I am, what I have in place, all the clearances. And this is why a copyright on that straw man and a lien on the straw man is so important. And the UCC affidavit. You can go to the Moorish American Consulate and download that UCC affidavit for free, right? You can contact us here. I'll put the link in the description below for the email for a copy of our UCC, but we filled out the actual form. Plus, we also did a bunch of other stuff. We did authenticate the birth certificate, and we did, when we did do the passport, we signed all rights reserved. So I say this to say that, people, if you're traveling out there, make certain that you have some law to back up what you're doing. And if you can't remember the law, write it down. And, you know, if you're traveling to the airport, have that on your in hand so that if you're stopped, all you have to do is hand it to them. So you're not left questioning, having these entities question you and then trying to figure out what to do. And worse, trying to phone now the Moorish American Consulate. And as you know, some of them have already been subjected to fraud as they're being jailed in Florida right now, which is what I was saying initially when this whole thing started. People need to prepare themselves and have law in hand so that in case something happens, they'll know how to lean. They'll know how to send a telepathic message. They'll know how to operate as an heir and send the angels in to protect them and the international authorities as they're protected internationally under the Vienna Convention, the diplomatic affairs, Article 3, Article 6, the Declaration of Independence, the Constitution, Article 4, unlawful search and seizure, Article 1, Section 6, all debts belong to the United States, and Article 1, Section 9. Somebody wrote to me about an IRS thing matter earlier. No one can lay taxes or levy taxes except the Congress. Congress has been adjourned since 1861. So know this stuff, you guys. Memorize this, sleep on this. This is the kind of stuff you need to know if you're traveling so that you're protected and everybody else is protected. And the worst part about it is when you have your own brother or sister classified as a black, working for these corporations, undermining your own position. And then you have a Hispanic or Puerto Rican or a Latino, also more, undermining your position and threatening you. They can also be sued. So you get their names. You write down the information that they give you, and you basically send them an affidavit, notice of lien, writ in the nature of discovery, adverse claim, estoppel, and you send that off, notice of future lien, notice of future lawsuit in the amount of, if you want to do 100 quadrillion, and a true bill for your time and the time it took for you to remedy this matter, right? And however much time you're put out as a result of your employment or whatever it is that you have to deal with. And you send it off to the department chief, head who's in charge. And then you CC that over to the United Nations, to the Universal Postal Union, and to the fraud department, and to Muriel Bowser doing business as mayor, and the comptroller of, the deeds, records and deeds in Washington, D.C. Send it off to them, and then you lien them basically. And then once you lien them, it's three long-form legal letters that you'd send in red, sign your name, and there's a 2-cent stamp on the back in the middle, right? You can write to us for that. Anyways, like, share, subscribe, you guys. Don't have to like this. This is not likable, but this is some serious stuff. Know who you are, and you must study, study, study. And do not depend on anyone to protect you from anything. You have to protect yourself all day, every day, right? That's what it's about. See, we knew this stuff a long time ago because we were subject to so much crap and we couldn't figure out what was going on until we got all this stuff put in place for us. And you got to secure up that straw man, lean that straw man, get a copyright on the straw man, do the UCC. Share, subscribe, have a great day.